Hi guys, I'm so excited today to share my writing setup for Notion, and this is a follow-up to my Scrivener tutorial for short form writing, which I'll link to here. In part one, I showed you how I organize all my drafts and write in Scrivener. In part two, I'm going to show you how I keep track of all those pieces and where I've submitted them. This is going to be somewhat similar to my Excel tutorial on tracking submissions, which I'll also link to here, just in case you prefer Excel to Notion. But honestly, I almost never use Excel now. I find Notion so much easier to navigate and update, and I like that I can link back to my databases in my main dashboard and see at a glance where all my pending pieces are. But more on the main dashboard some other day. For now, let's look at how I set up my writing dashboard. So we're gonna start with a blank page, call this writing projects. We're gonna make it an empty page, and we're gonna change it to full width. Then I'm gonna set up two columns initially. And that should make this so that I have two columns here. I like to keep track of all my current projects here, and then I usually put like a photo or something here that I find inspirational. I'm gonna make this title look slightly better. And then we're gonna start by creating a table view here. And these are tables that I already have, but we're just gonna click new database here. I'm gonna title this short pieces here too, but then I'm gonna hide this because I already have it up here. I'm gonna populate this with a few different columns, starting with a date column. I'm gonna drag this over here and title it date drafted. And then a select column. I'm gonna title this status. Move this here, leave tags where it is. And then I'm gonna add a submitted to column, but I'm gonna wait and add that after I have the submissions database ready. Just gonna clean up these columns. I'm gonna add my various status options. Make this one green. Make this one brown. This one's yellow. And this one's red. And then I also have an archive on. And we'll make that one purple. And then for tags, I have poem. I make this pink. And CNF. Because that's all I have right now. It'll make this blue, but you should probably also add fiction here. And we can make this purple. Next, let's make the table for the submissions in progress. So add another heading here. Make this blue as well. New database, and here we can just hide this. Here again, I add a date column, and that's going to be submission date. Then a number column for fees. Doesn't need to be so big. I'm just going to retitle this name of publications. I'm actually going to retitle this writing projects tutorial, so I know which one it is. I'm also gonna put a tutorial here and here. Then I'm gonna just add a few pieces here so that I can illustrate how this works. And then under publication, I'll put journal 1, 2, and 3. just to illustrate how this works. And then I'm going to add a relation property. I'm going to call this content. Now, when I submit to these journals, I can choose which content from up here. And then I'm gonna change this to say submitted to. And it'll say these publications over here. And that way I can keep track of where everything has been submitted. Next, I'm going to add three more select columns down here. First is genre. My options for genre are poetry, CNF, fiction, novel, award/contest, and application. And feel free to change these colors to whatever you prefer. You just click on this button and select. And I'm gonna move this here. And the next select column is gonna be submission type. There's really only two options here, for me at least. And that can be next to genre. And then I'm going to add another select column for status. Again, I'm going to be using Adrian Daw's unfortunately notation instead of rejected. A tiered unfortunately is like a tiered rejection, where it's not an acceptance, but it's also not a straight up rejection. There's like some comments that are promising, just so that I know which journals responded positively, because a lot of the time those journals might accept me in the future, and so it's good to just have an eye on them. And then I move this over here and I add one more column that is a date column, and that's going to be the status date. Put that next to status, and one more number column, and that's going to be payment. Actually, I put content right next to the name of the publication. So say that poem one was submitted via submittable and is pending currently since the 12th. And notice how it automatically appeared up here as being submitted to Journal 1. But then say that I also submitted it to Journal 2. Now they both show up here. Finally, I'm going to reconfigure this table so that it only appears in one column as I originally intended. And I can just add like an inspiring photo or something here. I'll just look at stock photos for writer. I like this one. And then I'm gonna add a cover. I love the art images that come up. Ooh, maybe this one. I realize this has nothing to do with writing, but I like the mood. And then I'll just quickly add an icon here. And that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that this was useful. Let me know if you have any comments or questions. I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll see you next time. Bye.